this company was going to come in, calling themselves Hydro Resource Incorporated, HRI, and they wanted to mine in this area. But at the same time, in this area, this is where our water table is. We're trying to let the mining company know that, you know, you, the mining company, will destroy our water. We call ourselves Eastern Navajo Dene against uranium mining. My name is Mitchell Capitan. Thank you for inviting me here. Tuokhet Lin in Shlong, not Nest Ezerbush's chin. Tana, Bilneda Shinalido, but Anida Shichi. The Kodoi distills the aid and Hirando Koi. Kehuite. What I've said was Amatuokhet Lini, which means water flows together. And then not Nest Ezmin, the Zuni clan. So that's who I am. This mine, which they are going use a technology called ISL mining, insulation leach mining, which they will use a lot of our water. And the reason why I really stand up to that is that I had some experience in ISL mining back in 1980 to 1986. Mobil Oil did a pilot project plant about six miles from here. After they have took the uranium, they were trying to restore the water. And it couldn't be done. You know, it seems like they took the uranium out of the surface for about 9 months. You know, they're pumping the ore body. But after that, they spent another 2.5 years trying to restore the water, and they couldn't do it. So this is the reason why, with my background, of my experience, of what I've seen, of what Mobil have done, and what ISL mining is, you know, it's just so impossible for them to mine here in our community of Crown Point. Around about 15,000 people, you know, in this community and the surrounding areas of other chapters are using our water. So a lot of people depend on this water that we have. We have a hospital, we have school, we have a technical college and a Navajo Community College. And it's going to be impossible and it's going to be irreversible to make this water clean again once they start injecting these kind of chemical into our water, our aquifer that we're trying to protect. So we've been going through this for the past 13 years, since 1994, yeah. It's still ongoing, yeah. I think it will set a precedence for all the indigenous people, you know, that opposes these kind of outside mining or whatever needs to, what is ever happening to our environment, you know, to destroy what we have here. And all we're doing is trying to protect what's ours, what we enjoy, and what we need to protect for our children to come. A lot of the younger people are understanding what we stand for, and they support us. In the long term, they'll understand, you know, what we have done.